sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, blind, but now I see.
Hi, I'm Aaron Torres. I'm my father's oldest son, and arguably the best looking as well. My father, he's such a wonderful man, and there's so many things I wish I could tell you about him. He is so much more than just the man that you see there at church every day. He's a very, very special in that he's not an extraordinary man. He's what you would call an extraordinary man. He has done so much with so very little. If you look at my dad, he's not the kind of guy who people look at and say, "Wow, what a handsome man." No. He's rather ordinary, looking. And when he speaks, well, you know, he's not very, he doesn't call a lot of attention to himself, but what he says is just so wonderful and so full of truth. And God has done so much with that rather ordinary gentleman that in my eyes is so wonderful that I think he inspires people. I think he inspires people who say, well, you know, if Brother Torres can do it, well, maybe I can as well. And I see that so much in his life. He is taught in school. He's been a teacher for many years. He was a president of a Bible college for so many years. And he was the president of our movement for many years. And he started out as a 15-year-old boy pastoring a church. And people there respected him as their pastor. He married people in the church there. And he started out a very, very humble man. And he excelled. And he was one of the very few ministers in our movement to get a bachelor's degree. That was back in the times when having a bachelor's was a very rare thing. And so I think that when he attained that, being the extraordinary man, I think he inspired a whole new generation of ministers who not only look for excellence in their ministry, but also look for excellence in education as well. There is so much, like I said, to this man. I could never ever tell you anything, but he has been a very good father, and I couldn't think of a better dad. I thank God that he could have put me anywhere on this planet, but he had the tender mercy of putting me in the house under the same roof as Joel B. Torres. And it's been such a pleasure, it's been such a wonderful odyssey of living and growing and being together with my mother and my father.
My husband's parents were born in Mexico. And they came to Texas when they were very young. They established themselves there. They used to work in the farms. And it was there that my father-in-law cried out to God. He was tired of his life of sin. And a few days later, some people came and gave him the gospel, and they readily accepted the Lord. Mis suegros vinieron a Texas, de Monterrey, México, de esa área. Y ahí fue que encontraron al Señor. Después de que mi suegro clamó al Señor, y unos hermanos vinieron y les dieron el Evangelio. They lived there for a while and worked there, then decided to go to Colorado. My father-in-law worked on the railroad those years. And they settled over there and attended a church. They were faithful members in a little church in a little town called Gil, Colorado. Mis suegros se fueron de Texas a un pueblecito en Colorado que se llama Gil. Un pueblecito pequeñito que ni nombres tenían las calles, tan pequeño que era. Cuando yo le escribía, el número de su caja postal era 4. Box 4, Gil, Colorado. That was his the postal address in the small town where they lived in Colorado. There, it was a very ordinary family, very humble. And they worked in the fields. My husband worked in the fields in the sugar beets and other crops in the summers when he wasn't in school. And he went to a little school there that went all the way from elementary to high school. It was a little building, and then he went to high school. Ahí mi esposo asistió a la escuela, en una escuelita chiquita. Su clase cuando se graduó eran 18 los miembros de la clase de high school. There were only 18 members of his high school when, senior class when he graduated. And while he was in high school, he always loved the Lord, and the teachers respected him a lot. And sometimes one of the teachers would ask him to bring a devotional to the class, and he would do that. Then one of the pastors that pastored in a little town, Millican, close by, asked him to come and be his assistant, and he was his assistant there for a while he was in high school. Mientras que estaba en la escuela superior, un pastor le pidió que le ayudara como asistente. Y luego cuando el pastor salió, los hermanos le pidieron que fuera su pastor. So he was there with as an assistant, and then when the pastor left, then the people asked him to be their pastor. So he would go on weekends. He was in high school, so he couldn't live over there.